Goodbye to you, my trusted friend. We've known each other since we were 9 or 10. Together we've climbed hills and trees, learned of love and ABC, skinned our hearts and skinned our knees. Goodbye, my friend, it's hard to die when all the birds are singing in the sky. Now that the spring is in the air, pretty girls are everywhere. Think of me and I'll be there. We had joy, we had fun, we had seasons in the sun. But the hills that we climbed were just seasons out of time.
Morning, C. Cole, tag team.
Back again.
Last time this year. Yes. Ooh,
crazy. Crazy to see. It is Tuesday, June 7th. It is A Cycle Day 5. One more day of school tomorrow. But I guess before we get on with our Student of the Month announcements, let's send it over to Mr. Payne for our final letter report for the year.
Yeah.
So take it away, Mr.
Thanks, Tag Team Champs. That was fantastic. C. Cole, last full day of school today. It's Tuesday. Here's your weather report. Temperatures today going to get close to 80 degrees. We got nice conditions right now. Some cumulus clouds hanging around. Temperatures are in the 70s, so it'll climb a little bit more. But then later on today, we're going to see some low-lying stratus clouds. Some showers can move in our area this afternoon, and that can hang around into this evening as temperatures then drop into the low 70s and then into the 60s tonight. So good morning, not a promising afternoon, but we could make it to at least the end of the day, maybe. All right, we'll have to see. Question of the day comes from Braden Ash, and he asks Mr. Payne, jellyfish, how do they get washed up on the shore? Can they still sting it if they're on the beach? Okay, so jellyfish do get washed up along the shore, especially here along the East Coast. Myrtle Beach is a big one that a lot of jellyfish get washed up on. And how does it happen? Well, it happens because of storms and currents. And when a storm happens, that can really pull all those jellyfish, and the current gets very strong, and that pulls them to the beach. The other thing that really hurts jellyfish is cold water currents. So a cold water current does rise up into this Atlantic Ocean right here. Then those jellyfish can die, and then they get washed up along the beach. Now, once they're washed up along the beach, they begin to die immediately. They need the oxygen from the water in order to survive, so they don't have that. But don't touch them. They can still sting. Now, the sting isn't going to be as powerful as if they were alive in the middle of the ocean, but it's still going to hurt, so don't test it. Brandon, thanks for that great question, as maybe some of us will be traveling to the shore this summer. See you, Cole. Have a great Tuesday. We got one more half day left. Tag Team Champs, back to you.
All right, thanks, Mr. Payne. Looks nice for a little bit today, and then maybe some rain.
Yeah, hopefully it holds off. I know there's graduations and all going on.
Yeah.
So, yeah. You know, hopefully that holds off for anybody who's dealing with that.
Speaking of graduation, I loved seeing those graduates yesterday.
That was really cool. Yeah. It was really cool. I was trying to remember all the kids that I had. Boys and girls, but the first year I worked here as an intern for Mrs. Fantastic, I worked with some of those students a lot through yesterday, so it's crazy how quick time goes.
Yeah, I had a lot of them, because I had some of them in fifth and some of them in sixth. A lot I recognized, some I didn't, but
yeah.
They made it.
Absolutely.
So congratulations to the graduates. All right, so speaking of congratulations, today is the final Student of the Month of the year. You will be having your recognition little celebration at 12:40 today. So those of you that are at lunch at that time or at recess might want to pay attention. So you will be going to Ms. Quillman's room for the recognition. So here we go. Final Student of the Month. Congratulations to all of the students. And again, I apologize if I mispronounced your name. Starting off with the Jessets and Red K team, Maddie Rothenberger. The Lillis and Monk team, Marlene Rodriguez. The Anagnost and Sola team, Chase Walton. The Feather and Gilmore team, Amelia Nova. And the Franzone and Quillman team, Briggs Cassidy. Congratulations, fourth grade. fifth grade, the Anton and James team, Julian Torres. The Painter and Mancavage team, Nefalti Gallo Pelagio. The Zubia May team, Malia Flowers. Sager and Kemmerer team, Stephen Quintero. And the Barbin and Sharp team, Jada Gonzalez. Congratulations, fifth grade. From the Williams and Fair team, Jalen Calderon. The Hawes and Myron team, Ariel Rosario. Bag and Sos and Ruber team, Ava Carabajal. Rankin and Colder team, Yalissa Gonzalez Perillo. And the Kapazinski and Freeze team, Ivan Flores Rivera. Congratulations. Virtual. Looks like we have some siblings here. From Mrs. Gross, virtual Elias Fernandez Batista. And Mr. Dong, Martin Bogdana. Sorry, Bogdava. And from Mrs. Wallace, Elian Fernandez Batista. Congratulations, virtual. Moving into specials from Phys Ed, Mr. Ango, Carter Burr from Mrs. May's class. Phys Ed from Mr. Gross, Jada Delgado from Mrs. Barbin's class. In art from Mrs. McGowan, Peyton Wagner in Mrs. Freeze's class. Music from Mr. DeWalt, Juliana Barber in Mr. Myron's class. Music from Mr. Reininger, Reynaldo Jimenez in Ms. Anton's class. Band from Mr. Figueroa, Sanaya Chopra in Mr. Coldren's class. In engineering from Ms. Nelson, Jeriel Hernandez Sepulveda from Mrs. Kemmerer's class. Guidance for fourth grade from Mrs. Siegfried, Addison Stout from Ms. Feather's class. Guidance from Mr. K in fifth grade, Braden Ash in Mrs. Sharp's class. And rounding out our list for the year, guidance from Mrs. Matasik in sixth grade, Melvin Vega in Mrs. Rupert's class. So congratulations to the May Student of the Month. Congratulations to all of you that have earned Student of the Month this year. Listen for that announcement today.
Yeah, well done, everybody. And if you didn't earn it, hey, keep working hard. There's next year as well, too. So keep improving yourselves. That's what it's all about. So other things for today, boys and girls, remember that you are returning all your library books. If you have any out, make sure that anything that you need to bring back to school, you are doing so. Other fun things today, it's C. Cole's own Dollar Dog Day, so enjoy the picnic soiree with our own crazy hot dog man, Mr. Klein, on the grill today.
Yeah.
So
third graders will be joining you in some of those lunch periods. And Chromebooks, they should already be returned along with your chargers. If you have not done that, you have one more day to get those returned.
Get them in.
That's it, I guess.
Yeah. Well,
have a great last full day. Tomorrow is a 12:40 dismissal. Remember, there is
12:10.
Sorry, not 12:40. 12:10. There is no lunch tomorrow. And Mr. Dong, I'm sure I know that you like to see the countdown. So, only 178 more days to go. 179 more. So we're going to go back in time because I know you like to see those big numbers.
Yeah. All right. See you, Cole.
Tag
have
team out. One last
out.
Time.
Yeah!